Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And before we continue, make sure to subscribe, hit that like button and turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload. So today we're doing materials from plants, animals and earth. So let us start. We use several things in our daily life. They may look and feel different. Some are hard and shiny. Some are hard and rough. Some are soft and can be stretched. They are different because they are made of different materials. We get many of these materials from nature. Some of them are obtained from plants and animals, and some are dug out from the earth. Plants and animals provide us with a variety of natural material that are very useful for humans. Let us look at a small summary of what we are going to see. Materials from plants: timber, paper, rubber, cotton, jute. Materials from animals: leather, wool and silk. Materials from the earth: glass, clay, metal and petroleum. Materials from plants. Materials from plants: timber or wood. We get timber from trees like teak. It is a porous and fibrous tissue that is found in stems and roots of trees and other woody plants. Wood is a multi-purpose asset given by nature to humans. It is hard and strong. It is insulating to heat and electricity. It is used as a fuel, as a construction material for making tools and weapons, furniture and paper. Secondary products such as furniture, building structures and component containers and musical instruments, artworks, sports equipment like cricket, hockey, billiard, table tennis, etc. Toys and sport equipments have long made use of wood for handles and main parts. The first step in furniture making is the selection of wood based on application. The tree is cut into pieces called lumber. The lumber is dried to reduce moisture. The dried wood is moved to the machine shop where different parts of the furniture are cut out and clamped together. Oil and paint bring out the beauty of wood. Now, in materials from plants, we're going to see paper. Paper is a thin material mainly used for writing, printing, drawing or for packaging. The wood from bamboo and pine trees is soft and mostly used to make paper. To make paper from trees, the raw wood has to be turned into pulp. This pulp is made of wood fibers and chemicals that are mixed together. They can either be processed mechanically or chemically. With chemical pulping, machines grind wood chips into pulp. Huge machines spray the pulp mixture onto moving mesh screens to make a layered mat. The mat is run through heated rolls to squeeze out any remaining water and compress it into one continuous roll of paper. Materials from plants: rubber. Rubber can be easily molded into various shapes and sizes. Rubber is used to manufacture gardening tools, pipes and hoses, manufacturing tires for different vehicles. Rubber is an excellent insulator. It does not allow heat or electricity to pass. Because of this property, rubber is used to make handles for different tools in industries and household materials. It allows an excellent grip on watery surfaces. Hence, rubber is used for manufacturing soles of shoe, gloves and other important equipment for better grip. This is why it is also used for flooring purposes. It offers proper friction to the surface and can avoid accidents. The properties of rubber include high strength and the capability to be stretched many times without breaking. Natural rubber is made by extracting a liquid sap called latex from certain types of trees. Latex is gathered from the trees by making a cut in the bark and collecting the runny sap in cups. This process is called tapping. Acid is then added to the mix to extract the rubber in a process called coagulation. This can take about 12 hours. This mixture is then passed through rollers to remove excess water. Once this is complete, the layers of rubber are hung over sacks, smokehouses, or left to air dry. Several days later, they will then be folded into bales ready for process. Materials from plants: cotton. Textile made of cotton are soft, feel durable, and has more absorbency. Cotton is frequently used for t-shirts, blue jeans, dresses, sweaters, and much more, bedsheets and towels. Since cotton is extremely soft and absorbent, it is an ideal fabric for bedroom liners and towel needed to soap up moisture. Cotton is a soft, fluffy, staple fiber that grows in a bowl or protective capsule around the seeds of cotton plants. Cotton is a natural fiber obtained from the plants of cotton balls. This harvesting machine, called a cotton picker, plucks fluffy seeds cotton out of plant's ball. The machine empties the plucked cotton into a tractor. A truck transports the mold to a processing plant known as cotton gin. Sticks and seeds are removed. The cotton lint is now ready to be formed into bales. Pipes feed the loose lint to the press area. When it arrives, a pusher moves the lint into a machine. Next, a conveyor moves the bale to a bagging machine. Now, materials from plants: jute. We get jute from jute plant. Jute is used to make bags and ropes. The fibers are also woven into curtains, chair coverings, carpet. The fibers are used alone or blended with other types of fibers to make twine and rope. It is very rough and is very difficult to cut or tear jute. Jute is an eco-friendly and biodegradable natural product with no adverse effect on the environment. After harvesting the jute plants, jute fibers are extracted by retting. Retting is the use of microorganisms and moisture on plants to dissolve cellular tissues surrounding fiber bundles so the fiber can be separated from the stem. The retting process consists of bundling jute stem together and immersing them in water. When stripping of the jute fiber is complete, extracted, jute stalks are dried in the open air, washed with water, and again dried on bamboo poles. The resultant fiber is then sold off to market mills to produce various products such as crafts, jute, textile, etc. Now, materials from plants: flax. The fibers from flax plant are used to make linen clothes. Now, materials from animals. Leather. Leather is a strong, flexible, and durable material obtained from the tanning or chemical treatment of animal skins. The most common leather come from cattle, sheep, goat, buffalo, pigs, cows, and aquatic animals such as seals and alligators. Leather can be used to make a variety of items, including clothing, footwear, handbags, furniture, tools, and sport equipment. Tanning. Tanning is the process of treating skins of animals to produce leather. A tannery is the place where the skins are processed. Here, unwanted hairs from the skins are removed. The fleshing machine cuts away unwanted fleshy matter and regulates leather thickness. The leather passes on to the next stage called trimming, where workers cut away useless or unwanted material from the edge of raw skin to give them a better shape or trim. Materials from animals: wool. Wool is the textile fiber obtained from sheep and other animals. Wool is the natural fabric obtained from hairs of animals spinned into yarns to produce warm clothing for winters. It is known for its durability. Thermally insulating property depends on various types of hairs of animals. After cotton, wool is the most used textile in the world. The first step in the wool production process is to shear the fleece coat of the wool-bearing animal. The wool is cleaned and fatty grease substance are removed using chemical additives. Then it is subjected and straightened the raw wool fibers into long strand in order to make it easier to spin into wool yarn. Spin the wool into yarn using a spinning machine. The yarn is now ready to be woven into wool garments or other wool textiles. Now, materials from animals: silk. Silk is a natural animal protein formed by certain kinds of worms. These worms are actually grown in captivity, and the cocoons they spin are used to make silk threads. These same threads are then woven into the beautiful and luxurious silk cloth. The silk is one of the toughest natural fibers. The greatest quality of silk is that this is breathable fabric. Silk is also a good heat absorbent, which helps you to keep warm in the cold night, while silk keeps the body cool in summer. Now, materials from earth: glass. Glass is made from liquid sand. Glass is such a popular material in our homes because it has all kinds of useful properties. Apart from being transparent, it is inexpensive to make, easy to shape when it's molten, reasonable resistance to heat when it's set. Chemically inert, that is, a glass jar doesn't react with the things you put inside it, and it can be recycled any number of times. Glass is unlimited and innovative material that has plenty of applications. In packaging, we use glass for jars for food, bottles for drinks, flacons for cosmetics and pharmaceuticals. As a tableware, we use glass in drinking glasses, plate, cups, bowls. In housing and building, we use glass for doors and windows. In application and electronics, we use glass for oven doors, cooktop, TV, computer screen, smartphones. You can make glass by heating ordinary sand, which is mostly made of silicon dioxide, until it melts and turns into a liquid. Sand melts at the incredibly high temperature of 1700 degrees Celsius or 3090 Fahrenheit. When molten sand cools, it does not turn back into the green tea yellow stuff you start out with. It goes a complete transformation and gains an entirely different inner structure. Now, materials from earth: clay. We use clay to make bricks, pots and tiles. The making process involves different stages such as clay refining, clay mixing, throw on the wheel, drying. In the initial stage, the clay is refined by removing the dust particles like stone, lumps and other impurities in the clay. This is done manually using fine nets to filter the dry clay. Now the raw materials are added with water to prepare the dough. The craftsmen mix the clay by stamping and crushing for better mixing of clay. The mixed clay is placed on the center of the wheel. Then the wheel is rotated. As the wheel starts rotating, the craftsmen start to shape the clay into the required form. Smoothen of the outer surface is done with the net cloth, and the patterns are done using sharp-edged metal pieces. The prepared articles are piled carefully and kept under very high temperature to make it dry. Now, materials from earth, metal. We use metal to make vessels, bodies, and engines of cars, buses, trains, and aeroplanes, machine electric items, wires, and many other materials. Copper and aluminium metals are used in making of electric wires as they have very low electric resistance and good electric conductivity. Silver and gold are used to make jewelry and coins. The thin foil made of silver and gold are used to decorate sweets. The aluminium foils are used in packaging medicines and food materials. Iron, copper, and aluminium metals are used in making of household utensils and factory equipment. Lead is used in making car batteries. Now, materials from earth, petroleum. Petroleum is a naturally occurring liquid found beneath the earth's surface that can be refined into fuel. Petroleum is fossil fuel, meaning that it can be created by the decomposition of organic matter over millions of years. Uses of petroleum. We get petrol, diesel, kerosene, wax, vaseline from petroleum. We get fertilizers from petroleum for agriculture. Synthetic dye, detergents, paints are also made from petroleum. Petroleum is used to make plastic. We make nylon, clothes, ropes, toys, bags, TV, radio cabinets, household items, parts of cars with plastic. Plastic do not rot like plants or animal material. This is useful property because materials made of plastic last for a long time, but there is a danger in using plastic things. When we throw them away, they stay in the soil and pollute it. So we should not use too many things made of plastic. Exclusive use of plastic is harmful for the environment. Therefore, we should try reduce, reuse, and recycle plastic. Reduce, reuse, recycle. These three R words are important part of sustainable living as they help to cut down on the amount of waste we have to throw away. Reduce. Reduce the amount of waste you produce. Here are some ways you can do this. Only buy what you need. Choose products with less packaging. Look for items that you can reuse. For example, use steel glass to drink water or use a cloth bag when you go shopping. Reuse. Reuse items as much as you can before replacing them. Refill a water bottle with water from home instead of buying a new one. Update your computer rather than throwing it out and getting a replacement. Avoid plastic bags and choose reusable, environmental friendly bags instead. Recycle. Recycle items whenever possible. Many plastic can be melted and made into new things. Sell or give old plastic items to a person who gets them recycled. That's it for this video. Make sure to subscribe, hit that like button and turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload. And I'll see you all next time. Goodbye!